Yeah, guys, Panasonic just announced today the GH5 Mark II. Of course, there are a lot of changes internally. Welcome addition for sure for some of the users and for those people who wants to have the GH5 Mark II as their first camera. But it is not for me. Even though, huh? Number one, there's a built-in Vlog L. But I don't use Vlog L and I use CineD all the time. Next is that the GH5 Mark II now has the ability to live stream straight out of the camera. Man, that's a huge feature, I guess, for those people who wants to have a straightforward system that can have or do a live stream out of the box using the GH5 Mark II without even needing a computer, just a Wi-Fi connection and you are good to go. But again, guys, that feature is not for me because number one, I have an HDMI converter, that's number one. I have a computer, number two. And of course, I can just plug this in using my Ecamm Live app, which is amazing, by the way. And I don't think that I will live stream straight out of the camera. There's also some changes, especially now that you can use the Cinelike D2 version or the Cinelike V2 version, whereas for the GH5, this one only uses the Cinelike D version, which is version number one, I would say. And the V2 or the D2 for the Cinelike D, I don't have a use for it right now because I'm still happy of the outcome of the clips of my GH5 as well as my G9, which I am using it right now to film this video. Next is that it has all of the internal changes, but the main body itself is basically the same. And maybe you've seen a lot of my videos and really I'm not a fan of the GH5's body. I love the G9's body and I really hope, Guys, I really hope that the GH6, which was also announced today, but it's not coming yet and we still have 7 more months to go of waiting time. So who knows when it will happen, basically in 2021. I just hope that the new GH6 will have the body like the G9 or maybe even the S5. Next is that you can now change the waveform size. For the GH5 Mark II, you can now easily change it. You can resize it however you want. But for me, I actually seldom use the waveform. I don't know, maybe, oh, why is this guy not using the waveform? Because sometimes I just figure it out with my eyes. What I see in the screen is what I follow. And speaking of which, guys, speaking of the screen of the GH5 is actually good enough, but this time around, the GH5 Mark II has a better screen in terms of brightness. That is a welcome addition, guys. I love bright screens. The brighter and better for me to see outdoors. So there you go, guys. Those are some of the reasons why I won't be buying the GH5 Mark II. And instead, wait for the GH6. Yeah, guys, so I'm really, really excited about it because now that Panasonic said it will have 4K 120p. Yeah, don't get me wrong, 60p is very nice and I love filming in 60p, especially for weddings. But of course, it would be very nice if we have 120p as an option and I would love and can't wait to use that for weddings and for other filming stuff. And actually, you can shoot in 60p as well in 5.7K, meaning more resolution than 4K, and it's a welcome addition for me because I can just crop every time I need the frame or that particular shot. And yeah, guys, it's kind of future proof for me, and I just wish that they will change the focusing mechanism from the DFD to now the face detection. I have the Sony ZV-1 and the focusing of that one is really amazing and I really, really love that camera because of it. So there you go, guys. I can't wait for the GH6. So now my question is, before I end this video, for the GH5 Mark II, is this the camera that you're looking for? Or are you going to skip it and just wait for the GH6? Also, if you're starting out, do you think that the GH5 Mark II is the one right for you? Let me know in the comment section below and let's discuss. So there you go, guys. That's about it for this video. If you find it helpful, give it a like. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. It will be greatly appreciated. And don't you forget to hit that bell notification icon to be notified with more awesome videos. So this has been Bernie. I will see you in the next video. Goodbye for now.